Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this session, I'm going to talk about two authors, William Langland and Sir John Manville. Let's talk about William Langland first. Before getting into this session, do subscribe my YouTube channel and get the updates about the upcoming lecture. Yes, William Langland was born in 1330 and he lived up to 1400s. William Langland is well known for a Piers Plowman. Okay, it is, you know, a popular work. It's an allegorical poetry which charges against the abuses in the government and churches and deplores the misery of people who are suffering without true leadership. And this poetry, Piers the Plowman, in which we could find the information about the poetry, but there is not much information about the poet William Langland's life. And this poem starts as the poet was roaming in a hill called Malvern Hills. He was roaming on the hills. On the basis of this reference, it was suggested that the poet was probably born at Cleobury Mortimer in Shropshire. But it has also been argued that a more likely location is in Herefordshire, which is between Colwell and Ledbury. Again, a recent researchers which proclaimed that some of his imagery suggested to be echoed in the poem. The Herefordshire location, which seems more conveniencing as the, you know, probable site, which describes in the poem, and hence this also more convincing as the area where Langland spent his early life. And this poetry, Piers the Plowman, which proclaims a substantial knowledge of the liturgy, the scriptures and traditional exegesis, and also, you know, a good grasp of basic theological principles, you know, proclaimed from this poem. So the poet held an ecclesiastical office of some kind. It is further, you know, it shows that the poet spent some time in London. Because there is a character in this poetry called Will. Will is the character in the poetry. This character, Will, who has an allegorical significance as the human will. This can be reflected a certain amount of autobiographical material. Okay, Will, the character who settles down with his wife and daughter in Cornhill, in a place, you know, Cornhill, which is a main thoroughfare near the center of 14th century London. And this poetry also contains references to Coke Lane. Okay, this is an area where London prostitutes were required to live, to the Flemish prostitutes of London. This area is said to be the principal market center of the city, to the court of Arches. And this one was in the London Church of St. Mary Lebo and to the Westminster. Therefore, the Langland lived in London for a time. Ecclesiastics of all kinds flocked to the city. It contained a famous ecclesiastical court of the Arches, which was mentioned in this, you know, poetry, the Cathedral of St. Paul, which was one of the most important ecclesiastical centers in the kingdom, as well as 110 churches and numerous chantries requiring priests. In addition to this, many bishops and abbots had residencies in the city, so that, you know, altogether opportunities for clerical employment were plentiful. There were, you know, clerical employments were huge. If Langland was the author of Richard the Redeless, or Redeless, a poem that has been described to him, he may have spent his last years in Bristol, but there is no much evidence that the poet who wrote this poetry. Well, that's it about William Langland. Let me move on to the next writer, Sir John Manville. Sir John Manville, who lived in the 14th century, we couldn't find the exact year he was born. He's an author of collection of travelers. Author of, you know, collection of travelers. Okay. Traveler's Tales from Around the World, The Voyage and Travels of Sir John Manville. Okay, this is generally known as The Travels of Sir John Manville. The tales are selections from the narratives of genuine travelers. and embellished with Manvely's additions and described as his own adventures. These collections are, you know, described as his own adventures. The actual author of the tales remains uncertain. Because it's a collection, so many writers, many authors involved in the collection of the stories. Actual author of the tales are uncertain as the existence of the English knight Sir John Manvilla himself. This book originated in French about 1356 till 1357. Then it was translated into many languages. In English, it was translated into English in 1375. The narrator Manvely identifies himself as a knight of St. Albans. He identified himself as a knight of St. Albans. Incapacitated by arthritic gout, he has undertaken to stave off boredom by writing of his travels. And this one opened on Michaelmas. M-I-C-H-E-A-E-L-M-A-S, Michaelmas Day, which is on September 29, 1322, and from there he returned in 1356. The 14th century chronicle Jean de Outremeaux of Lise, Jean, G-E-A-N-D-O-U-T-R-E-M-E-U-S-E, Jean de Outremeaux of Liege, L-I-E-G, who claimed that he knows the book's true author. He said, you know, he knows the author of the book, a local physician named Jean de Bourgogne. Jean de Bourgogne, B-O-U-R-G-O-G-N-E. And scholars afterwards speculated that de Outremeaux himself wrote the book. Modern historical research which revealed that de Outremeaux's tradition, but which has yielded a few more positive conclusions. The actual author of the travels remains unknown, which is uncertain. This is uncertain whether the book's true author ever traveled at all, since he selected his materials almost entirely from the encyclopedias and travel books available to him, including those by William of Boldenesel, B-O-L-D-E-N-S-E-L-E, and Friar Odoric of Pordenone, Odoric, O-D-O-R-I-C, of Pordenone. P-O-R-D-E-N-O-N-E. So the author who enriched these voyages with accounts of the history, customs, religious, read and legends of the religious visitor, culled from his remarkable wide reading, transforming the originals by his literary skills and genuine creative imagination. The lands that he describes in the poet, which included the realm of Prester John, P-R-E-S-T-R-G-O-J-Y-H-N, John, the land of darkness, and the abode of the 10 lost tribes of Israel. In his time, you know, though Manvely was famous as the greatest traveler of the Middle Ages, in the ensuing age of exploration, he lost his reputation as a truthful narrator. His book, notwithstanding, has always been popular and remains extremely readable. Well, that's it about Sir John Manvely. Okay, thanks for watching. Do subscribe my channel.